Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruh in the laws of life threatening illness. Any maka, any injury that is internal, which means from the lips and inward, it's inside the person's body. Even teeth are included in this, as we'll see at the very end over here of this little chapter, that toothaches and the like.
So too, if a person has a wound or an abscess,
we violate Shabbos in order to treat it properly.
And you don't have to have anyone evaluate the severity of the wound over here,
even if there are no experts or doctors around.
And the person who is sick doesn't say a word.
We do whatever we would normally do during the week in order to help this person, because internal injuries with blood that is bleeding and the like, it's much more dangerous than that which is on the outside of the body.
However, if a person recognizes the extent of this illness,
you could really wait and there won't be risk to the patient over here, and you won't have to be mechal Shabbos.
And then, of course, we don't violate the Shabbos.
And just that you should know that internal pains that a person has, that's not called an injury in regards to halacha, which means you can't be mechal Shabbos. So a person has some, feels internal pains, aches, stomach aches and the like, normally we would say you're not allowed to be mechal Shabbos. However, if a person has extreme, let's say they have extreme intestinal pains, they have a Crohn's disease, rachman al-san, something like that, intestinal type of malfunction, that of course is a simon, is a sign to deeper ailments that are going on, and therefore in that case, a person could desecrate the Shabbos.
Umisha chayshesh b'shinav, someone who has a toothache,
and it's hurting them very much on Shabbos. There's a tremendous amount of pain.
Until his whole body is weakened and he's got to get into the bed.
You can tell a non-Jew to please extract the tooth because it's hurting to such an extent, it's affecting the rest of his body as well.
Okay.
Maka Sha'al gav hayad. Yeah, if a person has a wound that's on the back of his hand, Mishal gav haregel, or on the top of his foot,
v'chein kol maka shenaseis machmas barzel,
any wound that's caused by iron over here,
v'al shchin shebepia tabas,
if a person has a boil that's in his rectum,
v'chein mishabolo aluka, a person swallowed a leech,
or a wild dog and the bite ended up biting him, which means there might be rabies there.
Or any crawling creature that bit him,
even if it's only you're uncertain whether or not such a bite is poisonous and could kill a person or not.
A person has a very high burning fever,
in all these cases, when mechal Shabbos to treat this person to make sure that they live.
However, if it's a common fever, which is not on the higher charts of temperature, which normally means we're not worried about some internal infection that's going on,
ain mechal, and then you cannot violate the Shabbos.
Nevertheless, if it's a fever that is very bothersome and he needs some kind of treatment on Shabbos to be able to reduce the fever and take care of him, you can tell a non-Jew to do that for you. Have a wonderful day.